Okay, I will just try to explain it over here. The top view of a square lamina of sides 30 mm is a rectangle of 30 cross 20. It is actually a square lamina. When it is inclined at one particular angle, it looks like a rectangle of 30 cross 20 in the top view. That is what the question states. And the longer edge of the rectangle is being parallel to both HP and VP. Okay, so that is what we have to keep in mind. So for the solution, we'll start with XY line first. And then the top view of the square lamina, he says. So it is actually a square lamina. So polygon, number of sides 4. Then don't forget to click edge option from the command prompt. And from here, 30 square, right? Then you are going to mark the front view. So that is the front view. So let us name it quickly. So this is A, B, C, and D. So in the front view, it will be B dash within the bracket A dash, and then it will be C dash within the bracket D dash. Okay, so this is the front view of the line. Now, in the top view, it looks like a rectangle of 30 cross 20. So in the top view, I need to draw it as a rectangle. So this is 30, 20, then 30, and then 20. So this is how it looks like in the top view. From the top view, it looks like a rectangle of 30 cross 20. So let me show the dimension so it becomes clear. So this is the square of 30 by 30. And this dimension is a rectangle. Upon inclination, it looks like a rectangle of 30 cross 20. So from this, I need to find the inclination with respect to HP. So the inclination would be, I'll project one line from here. Then another line I'm projecting from here. Okay. So now, if I name them, it will be much better. This is A, B, C, and D. So in the front view, this would be B dash, A dash. Okay. And somewhere over here on this line, I will get C dash and D dash. That I have to take care of over there. Right, so now I need to cut an arc over here of the length of the front view. Now if you just recall the previous problems, whatever front view line used to be here, we just used to copy it here and rotate it to the given angle because inclination of the surface with respect to HP was given. But here giving the instead of giving the inclination with the HP, they have given how it looks like in the top view after being inclined. So here we are doing it reverse. First I have drawn a rectangle of 30 cross 20. With this, I am going to find out inclination with HP. So whatever length is here, obviously same length has to be inclined here so that I can get a square rectangle of 30 cross 20. So this length is 30. So with this point as center, I'll cut an arc of 30 mm on this particular line. So I'll take arc, center start end. So this is the center point and arc length would be 30 mm, 30, enter, and then I'll cut the arc. So you can see that the arc is cutting here. So this is the point where I will get C dash and D dash. So we'll take a line and join from here. Okay. Then extra line, whichever is not required, I'll just trim it. Okay, right. So now if I measure the inclination of this, I'll get what is the inclination with respect to HP. So one part of the question where he is asking what is the inclination with VP and HP can be resolved here. Okay. So now let me measure the inclination with respect to HP and VP. Sorry, only with HP. So the inclination with HP is 48 degrees. So this is the one part of the question. Okay. So they have asked the inclination with both the plane, but both the plane inclination I cannot see in one single view. But here I have at least got what is the inclination with HP. To get the inclination with VP, I have to take the help of side view. Before that, now let us go to third position. In the third position, I need to make its longer side being parallel to both the plane. Yet that satisfies yet to be, that condition is yet to be satisfied. Because if you look, the longer side is 30 mm. So the 30 mm longer side is right now parallel to HP. Correct, this is horizontal plane. So right now the 30 mm is parallel to HP, but this line is perpendicular to VP. It is perpendicular to XY line. Obviously it means it is perpendicular to VP. So I have to make the longer edge of the rectangle parallel to both the plane. So when I have to make it parallel to both the plane, then only thing I can do is I should rotate this plane by 90 degrees so that AB or CD. When AB becomes parallel, obviously CD will also become parallel. I have to rotate it 90 degrees either clockwise or anti-clockwise so that this longer edge becomes parallel to XY line. It means when it is parallel to XY line, it means it is parallel to HP as well as it is parallel to VP. That is the one more condition we have to satisfy. So in the third position, what I will do is I'll just copy this rectangle. Okay. So I'll just copy, select everything, click on the copy button from modify. Just move it here. Then you select everything and rotate it by 90 degrees such that AB becomes AB or CD becomes parallel to XY line. So I'm going to use rotate command. So see, I'm going to rotate in this way. C is fixed. I'm going to click on reference. Then again C, D, and I want to rotate by 90 degrees, or else you can keep ortho on. Automatically it will rotate by 90 degrees. Okay. So this is the kind of projection I require. I'll use the move command. Move, and I will move the object a little bit closer. Okay. So now you can see that the longer edge AB, or you may say CD, is parallel to both the plane. It is parallel to XY line. It means it is parallel to HP as well as it is parallel to VP. So with the help of this, I will draw the final view. That is the top view. So AB is on XY line. It will come till there. So this is AB. Then on the same length, you will have C and D. So this is how the final image will look like. So just let me name it quickly. So this is coming from here. So it would be B. This would be A, because A coinciding. This would be D and this would be C. Okay. So this is how it will look like in its final position. So we have find the inclination with HP. We have satisfied one more condition that one of its longer edges parallel to both the plane. Still one more is left out. That is, I need to find the inclination with VP. So to find the inclination with VP, I have to take the help of side view, exactly like you used to do in projection of lines. So to find the side view, what we need to do is we'll draw one line, which is X1, Y1 line, the dividing line between the planes. Okay. So I have drawn this line. Now remember two things which I'm going to tell now, very specific. Side view will always come next to front view. Just remember this. If you want to get the side view, it will be always next to the front view only. So which is front view? This is the front view. So obviously next to that, here itself, I should get the side view. Okay. So that is first point. Second point is side view is always a combination of front views and top views. Okay. Whenever you want to get a side view of an object, it always comes out from the combination of front view and top view. So now how do I combine front view and top view? So top view is front view is simple. I can directly project lines here. I can get it. But top view also have to combine. So what I will do is I'll project the top view lines up to this x1, y1 line. Okay. And same length I have to project here. Right. So to get the same length, there are two options I can do. First option is I can draw a 45 degree line over here. Okay. So of some length, I don't bother about the length. Angle would be 45. Okay. So if I draw a line from here, this 20 mm, if I project this 20 mm line from here, for example, from here to here, I will just extend it a little bit extra in view and extend this little bit extra in view and trim it. Okay. And then I will project from here till here. So what I did is, if this is 20 mm, right? And if I'm projecting up to 45 degree and projecting up to this line, then this line from this point, the distance between this and this will also be 20 mm only, right? So because this is a 45 degree line, so if I draw x-axis 1 mm till this and project it, then obviously y will also be 1 mm only. That is why we draw this 45 degree line, so that whatever length is there, same length should be projected to the side view also. So remember, next to front view, you will get the side view, and next to top view, you have to draw this 45 degree line. So that is the easiest way to remember it. So now I have projected these two lines. Okay. So these two lines are carrying all the four points A, B, C, D. So from here, I have projected, from here, I have projected. So A and B are on this line, left side. D and C are on this line, which is on the right side. Now this I have projected from top. Now I need to project from front also. When I combine these two views, then I'm going to get the final projection. So let us do that. So I'm projecting A and B, right? So that is on the XY line. Then I'm projecting C and D also. Now let us start joining them one by one. So see here, A is here on the XY line, okay? And this A is also coming from here. It is on the XY line. So I'm going to get A point at this particular point. So let me name it there itself directly. A, I'm going to use a double dash. For side views, we always name it by double dash. So I got A point. Now let us come to B. So B from the top view is on this line, okay? And B from this side is also on the XY line. So B will also come at the same intersection point here itself. So where is A dash? On the same point, I'm going to get B dash also. So let me name that point also. So this will become B double dash. Okay. So this particular point where it is intersecting is A double dash and B double dash both together. Now coming to C and D. Now C is on this line. I know it. And C and D are on this line. So I have to join it till there. So I'll extend from here and join it till here. So the intersection of these two lines, this point is C double dash and D double dash. Both the points will come at this point. So single line. Here I'll name it as C double dash and D double dash. Okay. Now I need to join the side view lines. So the line will be joined like this. So this becomes your side view. This is the side view, which I'm going to make it as 0.5 mm thick. So this is the side view of the problem. But actual thing what he has asked, we need the inclination with HP and VP. So if I just draw one projection line straight to this, then the inclination below this line, below the side view, will give me inclination with HP, that is theta. And the inclination above this line to this will give me VP inclination, that is phi. So now just to cross check, already I know that inclination with HP is 48 degree. Correct? Already the inclination is here is 48 degree. So just to cross check, if I check this angle, see, this is 48 degree. The remaining angle is VP. So from here to here, the remaining angle is VP, 42 degree. Okay. So that is the solution for this problem. Whenever you require inclination with both VP and HP, you have to take the help of a side view to get the answer. So two things to remember: side view is always come next to front view, and next to the top view, you have to draw this 45 degree line so that you can combine top view and front view together. So this 48 degrees theta and 42 degrees phi. Okay, fine. So meeting. Just.